Already we have derived the expression for lensmaker's formula. Now we are going to solve the fifth problem in the sixth chapter. So this derivation is also based on lensmaker's formula. In the basic lensmaker's formula derivation, one lens is there. On either side of the lens, a single medium, that is air medium, was assumed. On the left side also the refractive index was taken as n1. On the right side also the medium with refractive index n1 was assumed. But here in this problem, on the left side of the lens, the refractive index value is n1. On the right side of the lens, another medium is there with refractive index n3. The refractive index of the lens portion, its refractive index is n2. So left side n1, lens portion n2, right side n3. So these are all the descriptions of the refractive index in this picture. So on the basis of this, we have to derive the new lensmaker's formula. Here we can use our previous derivation for further studies. Here I am going to write the general equation for the refraction at a spherical surface. So this is the equation, that one the spherical surface. For this we have to write the equation for refraction at a spherical surface must be written. What are the basic equation? N2 divided by V minus N1 divided by U is equal to N2 minus N1 divided by R must be written. This is a general equation. Make a note. By using this, we have to write the two equations. Later we have to add. First, this one to be assumed as the first surface. This one to be assumed as the second surface. Are you clear? First, we will take the first surface. Are you clear? First, we have to take the first surface. With respect to the first surface, here on the side, in this side, left side, N1 is there. Inside, N2 is there. Here, the object distance must be taken as U is equal to U. And the image distance, this is the image of the first surface. Therefore, the image distance must be taken as I dash. So, wherever the image distance V comes, that must be taken as V dash. This is for first surface. By using this, we have to alter the equation. Now I am going to write the equation for first surface. Are you clear? So the ray enters from which medium to which medium? N1 to N2. Therefore N2, that could be written as it is. What is the image distance? Image distance is V dash minus N1. Already N1 is there. N1. U, what is U? Object distance. There itself you can write U. Here N2, as it is, N2 can be written, N1 can be written, no change at all. Here the refractive index of the first surface can be taken as R1. Refractive index of the first surface can be taken as R1. So now we have got the first equation for first surface. Now I am going to write the equation 2 for the second surface. Surface 2. I am going to write the equation for the surface 2. For that I have to draw the diagram like this. Here the refractive index of the lens portion is N2. The ray, it moves from N2 refractive index medium to N3 refractive index medium. Are you clear? So here the important thing is, now this one will act as the object. Understood? This one, I dash, acts as the object for the second surface. Therefore, U should be taken as V dash. And this is the image of the second surface. Therefore, here image falls. Therefore, this distance, V is nothing but V. Are you clear? This image I dash, it acts as the object for the second surface. Therefore, U must be taken as V dash. This is the object. This is the image for the second surface. Therefore, V must be taken as V. Here, light enters from N2 to N3. Therefore, wherever N2 comes, it should be written as N3. Wherever N1 comes in the equation, that should be written as N2. Make a note. So, these are all the important things that should know. Wherever N2 comes, N3 must be written. Wherever N1 comes, you have to write N2. Look at the first equation. N2 is there. Instead of N2, substitute N3. V, what is V? Image distance. Image distance must be written as it is V. Minus N1. Instead of N1, substitute N2. Instead of U, substitute V dash, which is equal to, instead of N2, substitute N3, minus, instead of N1, substitute N2. Here the radius of curvature of this second surface can be taken as R2. Therefore, instead of R, substitute R2. Now we have got second equation. Now two equations are available. Now this first equation and second equation both have to be added. First equation and second equation to be added. Add them now. N2 divided by V dash minus N1 divided by U plus N3 divided by V minus N2 divided by V dash. Everything is substituted. Substitute this part. N2 minus N1 divided by R1 plus N3 minus N2 divided by R2 can be substituted. So everything is substituted. Find out any common factors are available with the different sign. Here N2 divided by V dash, N2 divided by V dash is there, both can be cancelled. So the remaining thing is this factor. Okay. Now we will continue the derivation. Here space is available. Now I am interchanging the factors. Finally, you are getting N3 divided by V minus N1 divided by U can be written. What are the rest of the factors? N2 minus N1 divided by R1 plus N3 minus N2 divided by R2. So this is the final expression we are getting. Now we have to check whether the answer is given in the same answer is given in the textbook. Here RHS factors are correct. Are you clear? RHS factors are correct. Some error may be there in the answer. I hope so. I will check it up later. I will tell you. Okay.